Hi, my name is Noah Gift, and I'm going to talk to you about how to take a Python function and map it to a command line tool with as little code as possible. We're going to use the Python Fire library, which is originated from Google, and let's go ahead and get started. Let's map a Python function to a command line tool. First, let's go ahead and define our function. We'll call this function fruit, and this fruit function will be something later we will map to a command line tool library, the Python library Fire. So here we have a fruit generator that accepts fruits, and then inside of here, I'll go ahead and import my random library, which I'll say from random import choices. Great. Now that I've got that, I can generate some kind of logic. And the logic that I will generate will be something that will just return back something useful. In this case, it'll be choices of fruits. So essentially randomly choose fruits to return back to the user. So this is a very simple function here. Not a lot of work, but let's go ahead and queue this up. So I'll add a doc string here, which returns back a random fruit. And then next, what I'll do is put my logic inside of here as well. And what I'll do is I'll print out my result here so I can just test out the basic script here, which will print out the fruit generator. And then I'll put in, let's say, a list of fruits, and then it'll pick one of those fruits to return back. So very simple random function here. I like to build random functions because they're nice to test with, since I'll get different values every time I test it. There we go. Hello, peach. Hello, apple. Right, I'm randomly choosing one of those fruits. So now that I've got this thing wired up, really the next step here is to figure out how to make this thing map to a command line tool library. And what I'll need to do is figure out essentially how to map this function directly into this Python Fire command line tool. So let's go ahead and take a look at how that would work next here. Okay, now we have Python Fire. You can see it's a simple way to generate command line tools from just any Python object. So one of the most efficient possible ways you can build a command line tool, you can see here's an example. I would just have a hello function, and then if I import fire, I can just fire.fire hello, right? This, in some senses, the shortest distance between two points is taking, I can't imagine actually a quicker way to write command line tools than a library like this. And so let's go ahead and do that ourselves. So I'm gonna first install it in my requirements file. So I'll say fire. I have a make file here, so I can just type in make install. Great, that works. And then next, what I can do is once I've got this thing wired up, is set this up inside of my script here. So I can turn a script basically into a command line tool very, very easily. So we'll say right here, import fire. That's great. Let's go ahead and do that, import fire. And then next here, I'll need to just follow this bottom syntax here. And this is something that confuses many people, is when you build a script in Python, you do need to put if under name under equals main. And the reason for this is to tell the Python interpreter that this is actually meant to be invoked only as a script. And so if I import this, it wouldn't actually invoke the code. It only will run if I run it as a script. And all command line tools will use this syntax so that it differentiates it. So when you see this block here, that's all it means. Now, if I go through here and I say fire.fire, this is where I would actually go through here and put in the fruit generator code. In this case, I'm actually trying this out to show how a mistake would be made. In this case, wait, what are we doing here? Ah, right. It gives me an error because of the fact that I actually am not calling a function. I'm just calling a variable that doesn't exist. Aha, here's the problem. And even if I go through and I do the help menu, it's still going to have the same issue, in that in this particular scenario here, I'm not actually able to invoke a function. So if I change it though to fruit generator, and then we go through and we do help. Aha, here we see that, in fact, I get all these fancy things here. We get the fact that it has a help menu. It tells me exactly what it takes. So this is really a great interface here for me to build up the next piece of logic. Okay, now that I have tried things out here, and I know that I need to tweak things a little bit, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add inside of here a little bit more logic. And what I'll do is I'll put in an array of different fruits, because the way I had the code before earlier, it was a little difficult to parse a list. And so I'll put the list inside of this function. Next, what I'll do is I will make it so that I will allow the user to append something to this internal list, and then it will randomly choose from this internal list in our command line tool. So this makes it a little bit more sophisticated and makes it easier to use. And that way I don't have to try to figure out how to parse a list, which is not necessarily conducive to the Bash terminal. So we'll go ahead and now try this out, and I'll put in a name of a fruit. In this case, I say pear, and it says, oh, there we go. So it randomly picked a cherry, but I did append pear to the internal list. Now this is a little bit difficult to see what's happening though. And so what it may be helpful to do is to add a little bit of logic in here that just shows what it is I'm putting into the command line tool, and then also what fruit is actually randomly selected. So without this logic, it might be confusing to the user to really understand what's happening. So we'll say you added this fruit, and I'll use an F string here to put this fruit inside. Next up, I'll go ahead and I'll say, here's the random fruit that was chosen. There we go, randomly selecting from all of the fruits. Great, and I'll put this as well inside of an F string. And this will then go and return back more information to the user of this command line tool. Python hello, pear, there we go. You're adding this fruit, pear, randomly selecting from all of the fruits. You can see that the pear that I passed in was actually returned to the command line. So we've actually made a much more useful command line tool.